Good day to all of you, ladies and gentlemen. This is Mr. Fire, and here we have, finally, the Jesus Christ character. This is a build which I call Jesus Christ, as we can see the name here of this build. Jesus Christ currently has finished Epic Difficulty. He has 0 deaths, and it is a Prophet class. Now, why do I call this build Jesus Christ? Some time ago, actually a long time ago, I started playing with a new character from level 1, before even Ragnarok came out. The idea with that character was to go ahead and max out this specific skill here, the Summon Wisp, at the add-on of the skill, which is the Eye of the Storm, and play with this skill as the main skill for the build. So, it was going to be something like a pet build, which was based on this skill here. That was a long time ago, before even Ragnarok came out. After Ragnarok came out, and of course now, after Atlantis came out, with Atlantis we got level 40 skills. We can see up here the level 40 skills. And we got this skill as well, which is a skill for this pet, Summon Wisp. So, now I felt that it was the time for me to recreate that build, give it a different name, because back then the build had the name Holy Spirit. This was supposed to be the Holy Spirit, and this is how I called the build back then. But after this came out and we got these skills here, I decided to recreate the character from the start. By the start I mean accomplish hero level 40 instantly. And now I decided to rename the build as well to Jesus Christ from Holy Spirit. And this is why. It is a thematic build. Actually, it is a fun build. It is a build that is based around this skill here, this pet, which is a skill at the same time. And of course, the idea is to max out all three skills here. The pet and the two add-ons of the pet. Now, this skill here is awesome because it deals damage to multiple enemies. But about skills, we will talk in a minute. So, this is what I did. I played normal difficulty as an accomplished hero, and then I played epic. I have 0 deaths. Wait, what? 0 deaths. Total deaths 0. And this build for epic difficulty is very powerful. Now, you can see here that I have 30 points available, attributes. At one point in epic difficulty, I decided to stop using my attribute points because I wanted to save the points for later. To keep the points to see if I can go through epic difficulty without spending these points, and if yes, then to keep these points, start playing legendary difficulty and see if in legendary difficulty I will need to invest these points on strength or intelligence or dexterity or maybe health. I don't think I have problems with energy. So, I'm not sure where to spend these points. This is why I saved 30 points for legendary. I haven't started legendary yet. I will start very soon, and we will talk about legendary things in the future. So, for now, what do we have? Let's go to the skills. We play. I have a couple of points only. I think only 1 point. I have spent 1 point on Spellbreaker and 1 on Spell Shock. I use this combination of skill. You know, it is very good to use. For example, when you fight against Typhon, the big boss in Olympus, Typhon gets his thorns out. When Typhon gets his thorns out, you attack Typhon, you take back damage of your own because Typhon deals damage reflection and also some damage retaliation when he has his thorns out. So, you cast this one on Typhon, you disrupt his thorns, and now he loses his thorns, and you can go and hit him ahead without being afraid that you will take back damage because you disrupt his damage retaliation and reflection. It is awesome. And you can use it the same in other enemies as well. Maybe some mage enemies, or maybe if you meet any Spellbreaker skeleton enemies that use Spellbreaker skills on you, you use this one on them before they use their Spellbreaker skill on you, and you disrupt their skills instead of them disrupting yours. We have, of course, the pet is maxed out at the two skills. This pet has 100% chance to avoid projectiles and to dodge attacks, which is awesome, which means it can never get hit by projectiles and attacks, but it can get hit by other AoE attacks, area of effect. So, yes, there is still a chance for your pet to get killed. This one at least. We have the Eye of the Storm, which you got to max it out because it supports the full party. It buffs the full party with more elemental damages and of course cold and lightning resistances. And you got to max out this one because this one hits multiple enemies. Sometimes this guy here attacks with the Thunderclap skill multiple enemies when you have this one active. And hitting multiple enemies means that many times it destroys enemies. We are not talking of course about bosses, but we are talking about multiple enemies at the same time attacking you and things like that. It is very helpful to go through the game faster because you kill more enemies faster. And it is a very powerful skill, it is awesome. It is a very good skill. And it is perfect, of course, for this idea of this Jesus Christ build, which in the beginning, about 2 years ago, it was called Holy Spirit build. Here we have, of course, Squall. You want to play with Squall, you use this one on enemies, especially on enemies that use rage attacks on you, because when they get hit by this one at level 12, they lose their aim on you, they do not hit you with their projectiles, because this is what this one does. It also has a good chance to deal some lightning damage. And of course you play Obscured Visibility, because every time an enemy gets hit with Squall and you have this one active, you reduce the damage that the enemies deal at you for 6 seconds, and also you reduce their resistances, which is also because they receive more damage. Even though, about the resistances, we'll come back to this one in a minute, this reduced resistances thing. Here we have the Storm Surge. I have it only at level 4. It is still good, of course, it helps, but so far so good. In epic difficulty I didn't have any problems, and this one wasn't necessary to be at maximum level, so everything is fine. In the future I will try to max it out, but I don't know if I can do it. I want to max out some other skills first before I come to this one. Here we have the Storm Nimbus. The Storm Nimbus is maxed out, and my plan is to max out the Heart of Frost and the Static Charge. Why? Because this skill works like an aura, which means you activate it once and it is always on until you get killed or until you lose all of your energy and you cannot keep it on. So, this one always, whenever you hit your enemy, you deal cold damage or lightning damage. One of these two. So, there is 50% chance to deal cold damage per hit or per attack, or 50% chance to deal lightning damage per attack. This one, it gives some very nice buffs, generic buffs, load attack retaliation and movement retaliation to enemies that hit you with melee attacks, but it also increases your cold damage and frostburn damage. This buff of cold damage and frostburn damage buffs this attack here, the skill of this one, but it also buffs all other skills and attacks of yours that deal cold damage or frostburn. Why? Because this is an aura, something like an aura skill, and this is why it affects all of your rest of skills, spells, everything. This one, we want to max out this one because of the chance of lightning retaliation, but also because it buffs our lightning damage and electrical burn damage. And it is similar to this one. It buffs all the damage of all of our skills and spells and attacks, not just of this one. So, this is a melee combat build. I always attack with my melee weapon. And this is why I go to max out this one, to get the most damage output possible. Another reason why I want to get the most damage possible and I'm maxing out these things here, is this skill. Lightning Dash. This skill is awesome. This skill is magnificent. This skill is splendid. This skill is outstanding. This skill is amazing. This skill is a beauty. This skill, I have no other word because English is not my native language and I don't speak English well. This skill is amazing. It gives you this movement speed buff every time you use it on enemies. And it makes you, it helps you run very fast on the battlefields, on the maps, you know, throughout the maps. And you travel very fast. It is a great skill if you want to do any farming. And you know, many times in this game, when you want to do farming, you have to run at very fast through big areas, big maps, and to cover distances as fast as possible. You have to have a very good movement speed so you can run very fast. So even if you don't have good movement speed and you have the skill, you click this skill on enemies in the distance. You are here, for example, your enemy is here, you click it there, and you run by, you gain a buff of a boost of plus 444% movement speed, and you run like the Flash, something like that, super very fast. This way you can cover long distances with this skill alone. Of course, so long as there are enemies scattered around in the map, so you can click enemies on a distance and move faster. This one also deals damage, of course, but it has only 29% chance of one of three effects, different effects: 200% total damage, lightning damage, and 1 second of freeze. 29% chance means that one of these three will get triggered only when this 29% chance is active, is triggered. So, this skill is not the best for killing enemies, at least on end game. For leveling up, playing normal and epic, if you have very good gear, then you boost your attacks with skills like these ones or any other skills and items. Then this skill also deals lots of damage to enemies in normal and epic difficulties. In legendary, we will see. I still haven't played legendary. This is the first time I use this skill because it is a new skill. And we will see what happens. Dream Mastery. In Dream Mastery, I'm playing with Trance of Wrath. Why? Because this one adds electrical damage, electrical burst damage over 4 seconds to enemies, they receive more damage. It is not a big amount, but anyway, it helps a tiny bit. It also disrupts enemies for 1 second, which is awesome. Because when you are in front of your enemies and you disrupt their attacks, you disrupt some very powerful skills of theirs, which means they cannot use their super powerful skills many times on you. And this means that you survive even better. And now for the reduced resistances for 4 seconds. Well, let's go back to Squall. Squall with obscured visibility says 41% reduced resistance for 6 seconds. When you have enemies in front of you, for example, this one is always active and it hits enemies because it affects enemies, because it is something like an aura. You have it always active. It is always active. You click it once, it is always active. When this one affects enemies, they get 40% reduced resistances for 4 seconds. But if you cast on the same enemies this skill, then they will get 41% reduced resistances for 6 seconds from this one, and this one will stop working. These two reduced resistances effects do not stack. So you cannot deal 81% reduced resistances. The highest number only applies. And okay, this one is only 1% more. It is the difference is insignificant, you could say, but it doesn't really matter. I'm using both of the skills because sometimes you have many enemies in the battlefield. You have some enemies in front of you, they get hit by this one, and you have some projectile razor enemies in a distance, which do not get affected by this one. And now you cast the Squall skill on those enemies far away, they get their resistances reduced along with their damage reduced, which means that yes, even if you don't hit those enemies in the distance affected by this one, because you hit enemies in front of you affected by this one, you have your pets. You have your Summon Wisp and you have your Summon Nightmare. At these pets, maybe they can hit enemies in the distance that are affected by this one, and they can kill them much faster. So, it is a good idea to have both of these skills maxed out. Of course, I have maxed out Lucid Dream because I get more damage, premonition because of the offensive and defensive ability, and temporal flux because this is awesome. Total speed, sets to avoid projectiles and slow resistance. It is totally awesome. I'm trying to max out the summon nightmare. I hope I can do it, but it requires many more skill points to be maxed out. But anyway, I will try to do it. This is one more pet, and I'm using it, of course, because it supports this build very nicely. How does it support the build? First of all, Hypnotic Gaze. This one also reduces resistances of enemies for 5 seconds and also causes 5 seconds of confusion. But it hits only a single target. It is a very nice skill. Of course, again, this one will not stack with this one or with Squall, but it doesn't matter because sometimes it hits enemies that are not affected by this one or this one. So it is okay. This is why I haven't maxed it out yet, but I have maxed out the Master Might because this one buffs the performance of all of our pets, not our character, only pets, which means that now, plus 60% total damage, this works also with this one and this one. It stacks. Plus 60% total damage stacks with this elemental damage buffs for this one and the whole party, and it stacks with this one, of course. And you can see now that this pet deals even more damage, much more damage with this one active. So, this one we could say is a supportive pet for this build. It is mostly a supportive pet because it helps dealing some damage. It is the numbers of damage of this pet is very small for now. If we max it out, it will get not very good amount of damage, but added to the damage of this one and my character, it will be okay. Now, here we have Distortion Field. Why? Because we get damage absorption and some physical retaliation. This one helps very much with survivability, so we want to max it out. It is almost maxed out. I have to put 2 more points to max it out. And here we have the Phantom Strike. I'm using this one because I play a melee build, and this one helps significantly when we hit enemies. It destroys enemies. And of course the Addon Dream Stealer, because it gives more, it adds more targets maximum for this one to hit. And of course it adds damage and energy leech. Energy leech is very important, and of course stun. Why energy leech is very important? Because sometimes when we don't have enough energy and we got more energy because we don't go to start drinking our energy potions, then we can hit enemies that have energy bars on them with this one, and then we steal their energy and we fill up our energy bar. And it is awesome. So, this is it with the skills of the build. We have the skills down here. Squall, Spellbreaker, Phantom Strike, Summon Nightmare, and of course the Wisp. And I have the other skills, the Trance of Wrath here, and Storm Nimbus here. Usually what I do with my builds is, because we have 2 quick slot bars, in my main bar I assign skills that are being used all the time. For example, Squall has a small recharge time. You use it and you use it again. And in my secondary bar, I have skills that work like Auras. For example, Storm Nimbus and Trance of Wrath. You click these skills once and they are active forever until you get killed or you lose all your energy and you don't have energy to pay for these skills to be active. As you can see, they are active. I don't need to hit these skills again. And I have the pets here as well because until they get killed, we don't need to hit again on their skills. But I have them also here. Now for the items. We can see that Jesus Christ looks awesome. I like very... Actually, he reminds me of a Roman gladiator, you know, ancient Roman gladiator. It is awesome looking, but it is also very good, at least for epic difficulty, it is a powerful build. The items that I'm using and also the attributes, when it comes to the attributes, we have problems. This build is a hybrid build actually. We play a Prophet class, which is mostly a mage class or a spell class, and we have strength mostly as a main attribute. We have intelligence, we get intelligence by masters at some items, And to dexterity, I have invested many attribute points on dexterity. I have invested many attribute points on strength. On health, nothing. On energy, nothing. On intelligence, nothing. Only strength, dexterity. Why? Well, items like this one, they require a lot of strength to be able to equip. Or this one. Yeah, this one. So, I have these two items on my character right now. They belong to the same set. They provide us bonus lightning resistance and strength. This one is upgraded. I upgraded this item when I finished Epic Difficulty with Jesus, and I got upgrades of Epic Difficulty, Epic Tier upgrades, which is a 16% armor protection and about 100 defensive ability. This was the upgrades that I got. It is good, it is not bad, but maybe I would prefer some resistances because my armor is already very good. And the defensive ability was already very good before the upgrade. But anyway, it is a random upgrade, you cannot do many things. Here we have this item, of course. These items are super very good. They belong to legendary difficulty. And I have them, and they are super powerful together for this build and many builds as well. We have the discs of money. Now, the funny thing about this item is that I equipped the discs of money, I had it in my stash. Then, I went through the game, I went in Mimer's Maze, and in Mimer's Maze with this build, the first time I visited Mimer's Maze, I encountered three, not one, but three doppelgangers of Jesus Christ. Three. And one of the three gave me, when I killed him, gave me the discs of money. And the discs of money that he gave me provided a little bit of better resistances. The numbers we are talking about is 2 or 3% difference. But all of the resistances were better. So, I ended up equipping this item instead of that one. And that item I will give to another character of mine in the future. Here we have the Demon Shield. This shield is great. It provides plus 1 to skills, life leech retaliation, many resistances. It is awesome for this build. I will keep it for now. For legendary, we will see. I will probably not replace it in legendary difficulty, but I don't know. We will see what happens. Here we have the Weightless Great Helm of the Tinkerer. I'm using this one first of all because it says reduction to all requirements. This one in combination with this one allow me to have this one equipped and this one, for example. And this one probably. Yes, this is why I'm using Weightless item and of the Tinkerer. As you can see, the Tinkerer allows to charms or relics to be attached to a Tinkerer item. In this one, I have attached an Epic Crystal of Erebos with Vitality Damage Resistance at plus 1 to all skills, but I haven't attached the second one. Why? Because I wasn't very sure what I would like to attach on this item as a second charm or relic. And I wanted to go reach legendary difficulty, start playing legendary difficulty, see which of my resistances are the worst, and maybe apply here a second component which would give me more resistances, or apply something else. So, I kept it as is because I wasn't sure what to put here. Here we have the Puppet Master's Talisman of Immortality. Bonus to all pets, which is awesome. But I'm also getting the health numbers, which is awesome. I have in my stash a Puppet Master Talisman of the Tinkerer, which is awesome, and I plan on equipping that one. But I haven't decided yet what relics and charms to attach on that Puppet Master Tinkerer amulet. This is why I'm not using it yet. I will go legendary difficulty and I will see what is the best thing that I can do with that item, not this one. Here we have Wraithlord's Kikos of the Tinkerer. Why this one? First of all, it is a Wraithlord, so it gives bonus to pets, but the bonus to pets is not the best bonus for this build. The best bonus would be elemental damage. Why? First of all, this skill here, this pet, deals physical and vitality damage. with this one here, Vitality Damage. Of course, Nightmare gets the best benefits from this item here. But this pet, Summon Wisp, will not get the best benefits. Wisp also gets Vitality Damage, but Wisp initially deals Elemental Damage, Lightning Damage. So, Lightning Damage. So, it would be much better for this build to go with a bonus to pet's Elemental Damage instead of Vitality. Because Wisp kills, it really kills enemies, many enemies with its attacks. Nightmare pet doesn't kill enemies, not many enemies with its attacks. So, it is better to go with the one pet that deals the most damage and it kills most enemies, more enemies than the other pet, which means that the best solution, the best trick would be one with bonus elemental damage to pets. So, as we can see, this build has lots of room for improvements, and the Tinkerer, I chose to go with Demon's Blood for more vitality, damage, resistance, and also star resistance, and Dionysus Wine Skin for more health, physical resistance, and bleeding resistance. What else do we have? This one, Symbol of the Polymath. The best artifact in the game, not the best, but the most efficient, the most versatile artifact in the game, because it benefits all classes, all builds. 100% of the builds, this one benefits. And I'm using it for now, because it helps with many things, including the ability of equipping items based on strength. And here we have it, Fervor of Lucidius. This is the weapon I chose to go with, because of the bonus to pets, of course. This is a pet build mainly. We try to make our Wisp pet to deal as much damage as possible. And this one with the 20% total damage helps very much. There are some other weapons, a couple of more weapons out there that provide this bonus to pets, total damage, attack damage, cover to health. But this one is better for this build, because first of all, this one is upgraded. I had this one upgraded with another character in the past, and I kept it in the storage space of another character, and I didn't need it, I wasn't using it with that other character. It was a free item, so I took it and I put it here, and now this item is awesome. It is totally awesome, truly awesome. And it also grants the skill on slot, which I have down here. And sometimes I hit my enemies with this one and I deal physical damage. Sometimes I hit my enemies with this one and I deal total damage, lightning damage, physical damage, because this one deals physical damage. And when you use this one, you also use this one at the same time. This one works with your weapons, so yeah, not shields, weapons only. So yeah, it is a great item, and the attack damage cover to health that I get from this item, 11% and 6%, this one is awesome. Why do I get two times this thing? Because one comes from the upgrade that I got when I upgraded this item in the past. The setup of items is very good, but we can see that we have room for improvements. This one here, this one here, this one here, this one here possibly, and maybe I would change my shield. Another thing that I will show you in a bit, but I will go and play a little bit to show you, is this item here. Grant skill Summon Wisp, activated on attack. So, with this one, Jesus Christ build can have two Wisps at the same time. But to gain the second Wisp, you have to attack enemies, and randomly this Wisp will activate, it will trigger, and after it triggers, it will be with you forever until it gets killed by a big AoE attack from some very big and powerful enemies. Let's go and do it. First of all, yeah, we talked about attributes, we talked about deaths, zero. My offensive ability is very good for epic difficulty, and it is good also for legendary, not for dealing critical damage, but at least for hitting enemies, which is what we want. And resistances in epic are awesome, but in legendary we will lose many resistances and we will have some problems. We will see what we will do with items in legendary. So, the final thing that I'm going to show you now is this one, the Summon Wisp from this item. Let's go and kill a couple of enemies. I will show you now the skill. I will use the Lightning Dash skill. We have some enemies here. Here, you use the skill and you run. And the great thing about the skill is that when there are very close by enemies, more enemies in the vicinity, and you have this one, you hold down this one on the initial target, and you kill the initial target by holding this one down, then you instantly can move on other enemies close by, because there is auto attack feature in the game, which means you don't have to click again. Let's where is it? Let me see. Let's go kill some other enemies. Yeah, you couldn't see that here. But we see now that we have a Summon Wisp level 35 and a Summon Wisp level 49. So, we know now that we have two Wisps. Let's use this one. You see that the Wisp is dealing damage. Actually, the Wisp is... the Wisp killed these enemies. I almost dealt no damage. Let's do this again. You see that Wisp is killing our enemies in epic difficulty. Yes, these are not, of course, bosses, but does it really matter? Did you see that? This was this attack, Arc Discharge from the Wisp. You cast the Squall. And we see that the Wisp is dealing lots of damage to these Giants. These are Giants, they have lots of health. And of course it stuns the Giants for not even a second, and it helps very much. So, this is a build, everybody. I have already made some live streams of this character, leveling up this character. I will do more in the near future on some live streams, of course. And we will have some more videos coming of this build in the future, with a build guide update, of course, for this build when I finish Legendary. And I will let you know how this build did in Legendary, what items I used, and what was the better method to use to go as good as possible through Legendary. Thanks for watching this video. If you haven't done so, subscribe. More content is coming. If you like what you see, of course, subscribe. And I will see you super very soon with more videos, not only of Titan Quest, but other games, and of course, more live streams. Have fun.